Hey guys, my name is Koyanche and welcome to episode 12 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about how you're able to automate ore processing using a Tinker's Construct smeltery using logistics pipes. And this episode we'll start talking about how you're able to automate the creation of Buildcraft chipsets, again using logistics pipes. So let's get started. So, like always, I got myself a pretty cool tutorial world for you set up to pretty much demonstrate what I want to show you guys today, which is not only how to automate the crafting of the chipsets, but also to automatically keep a certain amount of them supplied in your network, so when you actually need them, you won't need to wait so extremely long, because the creation takes quite some time, as you may recall, using these Buildcraft lasers. So, let's get started. So, like always, I got myself a logistics power junction to provide power to the network, a creative energy cell to do so. And because I want this setup to be a little bit more logistics pipes based than normal, I also got myself a logistics RF power provider to make sure that these lasers also get power through logistics pipes and not any other power method, so that is pretty cool. So as you recall, to make that work, I talked about that in a previous episode, so be sure to check that out. But if you don't recall, pretty much you need a power transport upgrade in each corner that intersects where you want the power to go through. And in this case, a thermal expansion power upgrade, something like that, in each of these basic logistics pipes. Pretty cool. To check that out, you will need one of these logistics pipe controllers. As you can see, the thermal expansion power supplier upgrade. And in these corners, all just the power transportation upgrade. Pretty cool. Then, like always, right here, I got myself a couple of chests set up. First one is the provider module, polymorphic item sync module 1, which is just your general storage, where you will be storing the items that are required to make the chipsets. A random basic route chest, or default route, I should say. And a chest with a request logistics pipe, so I can actually request the production of, you know, certain chips in this network. Then onto the magic, why you are most likely here, the actual automation of the chipsets. This can be a little bit tricky, but I hope you guys will follow me. So, as to be expected, I got myself a assembly table right here, that is already set to be able to craft golden chipsets, iron chipsets, and diamond chipsets. You have to keep in mind that you cannot create recipes using this method that involve things like just the redstone chipsets, because that will severely mess up the recipe. So only things that are unique, resources pretty much. So what I did is in this logistics chest pipe Mark IV connected to the chest right here, because the assembly table outputs to any nearby inventory, I got myself three modules. Each one set up to have a satellite pipe to satellite 1, which is the satellite pipe next to it, to be diamond, gold or iron and a piece of redstone, and you get yourself the corresponding chipset. Same with these, I'm not sure why the satellite pipe just reset, not supposed to be, it's set to the specific satellite pipe, pretty cool. And then like I said, the satellite pipe is set to the ID you configured right here. So that on its own is already pretty much all you need to actually automate the crafting of these chipsets. But like I mentioned, I'm going a little bit further than actually, just the crafting, because it's always useful to have a certain amount of them supplied. Honestly, it's surprisingly simple. I really wondered why I didn't think of this earlier. So all I have to do for this is make myself a little bit of a buffer chest, which is pretty much the location where you want the chipsets to be stored, until you actually request them from a different location. So all I have to do is hook up a provider logistics pipe to a chest to pretty much make sure that the contents of this chest will be able to be sent from this chest to any other location in your network, and a supplier logistics pipe set up to keep stocked the amount of chipsets that you want to have at all times. So in this case, 8 iron, 8 golden and 8 diamond chipsets. And make sure to set the request mode to partial to make this work perfectly. So of course, let's quickly demonstrate to you guys what happens if I were to request, for example, 2 iron chipsets. Instead of having to wait, it will automatically take it from the buffer chest, send it to here. And because the supplier will kick in, it will automatically request 2 more of the recipe from the resources that you have in your network. Send it to the assembly table to perform the crafting. Of course, these lasers will automatically kick in through the power supplied through this network. Pretty awesome, as you can see, like follows. Then the chips, when produced, will be sent through this chest. The chest will automatically take it out and send to the requested location, which is this supplier pipe, which is pretty cool because supplier pipes can automatically perform crafting tasks, so pretty sweet. And then this chest will automatically be filled with the buffered goods, as you can see right there. So with this situation, I can pretty much always get 8 of these chipsets that I want at any time without having to wait until, of course, you run out of these. And if you have like a very big setup or very complicated recipes, you can set these to be a lot more, like 16 or even a stack. Keep a stack of them stored at a time. So that is pretty awesome. And with that, guys, I will be wrapping up this episode. Like always, I hope you found it very useful and educational, and of course, a little bit entertaining, which is always quite useful. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, like always, and hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.